So let's say you got a problem that asks you to factor this expression, 2x squared plus 5x minus 3. If your teacher lets you use a graphing calculator, the best way to do this, or not the best way, but an easy way to do this, is to graph it. So in your graphing calculator, plug in y equals this, that expression, and what you'll get is something like this. I'm not exactly right, but you'll get a parabola that's like that, and what you want to look for are the two intercepts. Here's one intercept right there at 1/2, and here's another one at -3. And you could find those a couple ways. You can either just kind of search, look at it, and if it's easy, obvious to see, you might be able to tell easily. But you could also do a find zero. You could go to calculate on the TI-83s, 84s, 85s. You could go to like the calculate button and then zero, and then it will tell you. You'll put a left point in. So you'll do something like this. You'll put like left point somewhere over here and a right point somewhere over here, and it'll find this one for you, and it'll say -3, 0. It'll find that zero for you. And then do the same thing for this right one, because you can see there's a zero somewhere between 0 and +1. And when you do that, you'll find it. So when you find that, what you want to do is kind of work backward if you remember solving equations. So write x equals -3, there's one of my zeros, and now solve that for 0. In other words, move everything over to one side. X plus 3 equals 0, and there's one of your factors. So one of my factors here I know has to be x plus 3. Then you can find the other factor very easily, because if you have x plus 3, then this, whatever's right here, has to multiply with the x to make 2x. So what does that have to be? 2x, good. And whatever's right here has to multiply with 3 to make -3. And what is that? -1. And so now you can just check to make sure it worked. 6x, -1x, those add together to make 5x, and you're good. So that's one way you can factor, is by going backward. The other way you can factor is by taking 2x squared plus 5x minus 3, was it? And just doing what's called guess and check. There's other ways you can factor, but this is really what you're doing, is you're trying to divide this out into two different factors. Because remember, what ultimately you had is you had these two things, these two linear factors multiplied together, and when you foiled it out, your f was your first term, your o plus your I was your middle term, and your l was your last term in the foil process. First, outside, inside, last. So you're undoing that. You're going backward from that. So this right here is your first. That has to be here and here. So how can I break up 2x squared? There's not very many ways I can break it up. It's pretty much got to be 2x and x, right? So I write 2x and x. And now to get my last, let me change the colors here, to get my last, I have to break up -3. And it really can only be 3 times -3 or -3 times 3. There's not very many things you can do, but you can also, three times -1 or -3 times 1. And so just guess and check. If you had tried putting a -3 there and a +1 there, when you checked it, you would get -3x plus 2x, and those don't add up to +5x. So that's not it. So try something else. Instead of -3, why don't you try -3 here and +1? Just move them around. And now check. You get 1x and -6x. Do those add up to +5x? Nope, but it's close. All you have to do is change this to a negative and that to a positive. and now you'll have a positive 6 and a negative 1, and those do add up to a positive 5. So factoring is just a fancy word for dividing. You're just trying to divide this quadratic out into two linear terms. And by the way, it won't always work because not every expression factors. But if it does factor, it will have to be something like that because of that situation. So that's just one of the more difficult types of problems that you'll see. So let's make another one. So here's another example. Now this one looks a little bit trickier, but really don't get confused by the z to the fourth and the z squared. Really, all you have to do is think to yourself, what does 6z to the fourth break up into? Well, it's got to be something z squared times something else z squared, right? So your options are 6 and 1 or 3z squared and 2z squared. Because those multiply to 6, right? Or they could be negatives. Or you could include the negatives of them. Okay? And then 5 breaks up into... It can either be 5 times negative 1 or negative 1 times 5. But also you can move those around a little bit in your order. So now let's just guess and check. Okay? So this just takes practice. All right, so I'm gonna just guess and check. I'm gonna think, and it's kind of like a game of chess. The more you do it, the better you get at guessing. I'm gonna guess 3z squared and 2z squared. I'm not gonna make them negative. And now I'm looking at negative 13 and I'm thinking, this is where the chess comes in. 3 times 5, or negative 5, ooh, that's a big number. That's negative 15. That's pretty close to negative 13, isn't it? So if that's a negative 5, this would have to be a positive 1. And a positive 1 times 2 is positive 2. Hey, I think that works. Because my outside is 15z squared, and my inside, I'm sorry, negative 15z squared, and my inside is 2z squared, and when I add those together, I get negative 13z squared. So when I add the outside and the inside together, I get negative 13z squared. So let's check it. Let's check if that worked. I'm going to write it out down here so I can show my work underneath it. Whoops. 3z squared plus 1 times 2z squared minus 5. Okay, where did I get those again? The 3 times the 2 gave me 6, z to the 4th, and that was my first. Then 1 and the negative 5 gave me negative 5, that was my last. And then the O plus the I, here's the O in your foil, and here's the I, should give me negative 13z squared. So let's see if that works. What's the first? What's 3z squared times 2z squared? 6z squared. There we go. There's my first. Now what's my outside? My outside, I'm doing the foil. Plus 15z squared. My outside means I'm multiplying the 3z squared times the negative 5. What's 3z squared times negative 5? Whoops, I put positive. It should be what? It should be negative 15z squared. Now what's the inside? The inside in my foil, right? F-O-I-L, first, outside, inside, last. The inside is 1 times 2z squared. What's 1 times 2z squared? It's plus 2z squared. It's positive 2z squared. And then what's the last? What's 1 times negative 5? Negative 5. Whoops. I made a mistake here. It shouldn't be z squared. Yeah, it should be z to the 4th. Yep. So now what does this add up to? There you go. 6z to the fourth minus 13z squared minus 5. And it worked. So this is the correct answer. That's the factored form. Also, you want to check to make sure it can't factor more. Because we, right now we have a z squared here, so that's a quadratic. There's a chance that that could factor more. But neither one of these factor more because they're binomials. And the only time you have a binomial that factors in a quadratic binomial is when it's a difference of perfect squares, like x squared minus 9. That would factor into x plus 3, x minus 3. Because really you have a plus 0x in the middle. Right? And so your inside and your outside are going to cancel each other out. Positive 3x and negative 3x will cancel each other out.